So right now isn't the best time for Bulls fans. The Bulls are currently on a 4-game losing streak. We've had multiple players get injured as of late or entered protocols. This coming after a 9-game winning streak. So we were all riding the high of how great the season was going. The Bulls were exceeding everyone's expectations, sitting pretty at the top of the Eastern Conference. But then things started to take a bit of a turn. And that even applied towards the end of the winning streak. Like, as incredible as those back-to-back game winners were against the Pacers and the Wizards, the Bulls really didn't play that well in those games. Same with the game against the Magic at home, where it was a closely fought game throughout the whole 48 minutes, and the Magic were without 7 guys on their roster. So what happened? Well, obviously, it's a number of factors. You can't really say it's all because of one sole reason. Obviously, guys going in and out of protocols, disrupting the team chemistry never helps. Players getting injured, also not ideal. But one of the main factors, in my opinion anyway, has been because of the defensive impact that Alex Caruso provides for this basketball team. And that's what we'll be discussing in this video. So what's going on, everyone? You are listening to Bulls Central here. Hope you're all doing well. Now, I know for some, this might seem like a no-brainer, because a fair amount of people recognize and understand the impact and value that Caruso brings to the court. And I know some will say, well, you need to stop overrating Caruso. Like, when people call him the Ball of Mamba or the GOAT, it turns what is otherwise an underrated player into an overrated player because of all these GOAT comments. Which, by the way, I made a dedicated video on Alex Caruso a couple months ago talking about why people call him the GOAT, and I can't tell you how many people commented on that video that I am out of my mind thinking that he's the greatest of all time. Like, really, guys? It's clearly a joke. No one in their right mind, especially a Bulls fan, would ever think that Alex Caruso is the greatest basketball player of all time. So for all those who came at me in the comments in that video, understand that it was sarcasm and have some common sense, because no single person would legitimately think that Caruso is the greatest of all time. That title sits with Michael Jordan, of course. But anyway, that rant aside, Caruso's impact and what he brings to this Bulls team, I feel, is oftentimes overlooked. I'm not saying by everybody, but by a fair amount of fans. Everyone is always talking about DeMar DeRozan or Zach LaVine or even Lonzo Ball and how impactful they have been to the Bulls this season. Which, they have been huge pieces, don't get me wrong. The Bulls don't even come close to the number of wins they currently have without LaVine and DeRozan. But there's also something to be said about having those glue guys who understand their role, who understand what is needed at a given point in time in a game, who have the awareness on the court for what type of support is needed from them on a given possession, and above all, a player that is a defensive specialist who isn't afraid to get dirty and fighting for loose balls, who has superb technique in how he pesters his opponents on defense to where he doesn't commit fouls, and a guy who just straight up hustles and brings energy to the team. And that's what Alex Caruso is to the Bulls. Let me throw out some numbers for you guys. So Alex Caruso has missed 13 straight games for the Bulls between injuries and also entering the health and safety protocol. And in those 13 games, that period, the Bulls are 24th in the league on defense. Now, granted, that's not all because of Caruso, especially when you factor in that Javonte Green has missed the last 8 games, Derek Jones Jr. has missed the last 4 games, and of course, Lonzo Ball has been out for a period of time in those 13 games. But you have to remember that Alex Caruso is a top 5 player in the league in terms of point of attack defense. Last season, he was actually number 1 in the league in point of attack defense. The Bulls, prior to Caruso missing these past 13 games, were 8th in the league in defensive rating. They now sit 18th in the NBA. A stat that I thought was really telling was something that Mark Kay from the Bulls HQ podcast tweeted about yesterday, which, by the way, I'm going to be having Mark on the channel later this week, so be on the lookout for that. But he called out that the Bulls are plus 8.4 points per 100 possessions when Caruso is on the floor, and plus 0.76 points per possession when Javonte Green is on the floor. Now, because Caruso has missed 13 straight games, 15 on the season, he doesn't qualify for some of the top statistical leaderboards, but prior to his injury, Caruso was leading the league in steals at 2 steals per game, and this being in 28 minutes of play coming off the bench. You factor in his steals per 100 possessions, and he's posting 3.5 steals per game, which also leads the league. Caruso leads the Bulls in defensive rating, defensive box plus minus, as well as defensive win shares. Now, obviously, the Bulls' offense has gone up dramatically in that period when you look at their overall offensive rating as well as their overall points per game in the past 13 games since Caruso has been out. But what's also important noting is the overall efficiency on the offensive end and how that slipped, specifically from DeMar DeRozan. Now, I mentioned this in my last video, that DeMar has been great. This isn't taking away what he's been able to do for this Bulls team and helping bringing them back to relevancy. But over the past few games, DeRozan hasn't looked like his usual self. Not saying he's completely fallen off, but his shooting numbers have dropped. He's turning the ball over more frequently, and he hasn't been drawing as much contact and getting to the line. Now, why is that important as it relates to Caruso? Well, because without Caruso's lockdown defense and his ability to get steals, leading to the Bulls operating quickly in transition, DeRozan isn't able to get to his spots as frequently as he would like. And because the Bulls' overall pace has slowed down, teams defending the Bulls are much better able to keep up. You have also seen this with Zach LaVine to an extent before he got injured, and his ability to operate quickly and smoothly because him and DeRozan didn't need to focus and exert as much of their energy on defense when they had guys like Lonzo and Caruso defending the perimeter. And of course, Javonte at the power forward spot as well. Like, when the Bulls' defense is limited, guys like DeRozan, LaVine, and Vucevic have to step up on the defensive end, which means balancing their effort on offense. And most recently, you've seen guys like DeRozan, especially Vucevic, straight up giving up on plays on defense. Plays they were used to others stepping in on. Guys like Caruso and Javonte Green who hustle on that end of the floor. Now, there is always something to be said about guys feeding off the energy of other players. That infectious energy that even when you're down, momentum isn't on your side, but you have a guy who is still hyping the team, motivating them to work hard because they see how hard they're working and fighting on every possession. That energy trickles down to the rest of the team. And that's exactly the type of energy Alex Caruso brings. He's a vocal player on and off the court, telling guys where they need to be on the court, shouting out screens, calling switches, a high IQ player that knows what to do to make his team successful and utilizing his strengths and the strengths of others to their fullest. I mean, I know this is a bit of a stretch, but look at how the Lakers have been faring now that Caruso is no longer on the team. Yes, a lot of other factors at play with new guys on that roster, but the Lakers are currently 21-22, ninth in the West. They're one of the worst teams in the league in points per game allowed at 113.3 and 20th in defensive rating. Again, a bit of a stretch because the Lakers have a lot of other newcomers on their roster, but there is something to be said on how much the Lakers have fallen defensively since Caruso has left the team. Now, I don't want this to take away from the level of impact a guy like Javonte Green brings as well, and I will be doing a dedicated video on Javonte at some point this season, just because he's another guy who does everything he's asked, knows his role, doesn't let his ego get in the way, hustles on both ends of the floor, and is one of the Bulls' most underrated players when you look at his on-off-court numbers, and again, especially on defense. And you also can't forget about Derrick Jones Jr., who had been immensely impactful on the defensive end with his length and athleticism. Derrick Jones Jr. is actually the Bulls' best shot blocker per 100 possessions and per 36 minutes, which is incredible for a guy who was only 6'6". And he's been able to step up in a massive way in playing the four spot for a guy who's traditionally a three. The same also goes for Javonte Green, who is 6'4 guard and plays like he's a 6'9 power forward and holds his own while doing so. So look, it's because of this that I'm not that worried for the Bulls' recent slump and four-game losing streak, because they're missing key players that elevate their overall defensive intensity and glue guys who have been instrumental in their success. Now, hopefully, this past game against the Grizzlies is the last one that Alex Caruso misses, as Billy Donovan did confirm that he has exited protocols and they will make a decision on his status for the game tomorrow against the Cavs based on how he responds in practice and how his conditioning looks. Billy Donovan did say that he will likely be on a minutes restriction because of how long he has been out, but that is encouraging to hear nonetheless. We did also learn that Javonte Green is nearing a return, although Donovan didn't sound as optimistic for Green to return on Wednesday and more likely to happen on Friday against the Bucks, which will certainly need him for that. So hopefully, if Caruso is back in the lineup for tomorrow's game, we'll see a much more energized, a much more efficient team on the defensive end, and hopefully the Bulls can end their losing streak and get back on the winning side of the standings. I would love to hear what you guys think, though. What do you think has been impacting the Bulls the most in this recent slump? Let me know in the comments. And guys, as always, be sure to subscribe if you're a Bulls fan, as I do post daily Bulls content. Thanks again for tuning in, guys, and I will catch you in the next one.